was making any noise. Not really making too much noise. Okay. We're in the Harrier, we're in the Shetland Islands, Sumborg. And we're going to go north, we're going to head up to the radar head, which is the most northern tip of the United Kingdom. So, without further ado, brakes off. Look at the traffic crossing my runway. You got any traffic lights? Better go quick. Still crossing. Okay. Okay, you can come up. Flaps up. Nozzles up. Let's go north. Been to the Shetland Islands before. This is it. Yeah, but it's right at the bottom and it's like a long streaky piece of bacon. And the radar head, Saxa Vord, is right at the top. It's a train. Just trundle along with that. Oh, what's that doing? Put it down here somewhere. Out the way. Yes, this radar head where we're going. It was pretty much obsolete, really, old equipment, and they renewed it. They put all new stuff up there a few years ago because they felt that the Russians were active again. And this is watching UK airspace from the most northern tip. In fact, it has unofficially recorded the highest wind in the UK. It got up to just under 200 miles an hour before the recording equipment blew away. Right, I need to stay. Of these islands, it's not visual. We're right out in the North Atlantic here. The waters are rather chilly. So if you ever want to go to the most northern tip of the United Kingdom, this is going to be it. We should be over there somewhere. Just got an island hop. All the way across. I'm on the Oculus Quest 2. It's the first time I've flown the Harrier with the Oculus Quest 2. And it's remarkably good actually. I like it. Still got the light bit in the right eye though. I guess that must be normal. Thing is, I used to record from the right side. My video settings, it won't allow me to record VR because it doesn't recognise the VR headset, so I've got to have it on record game. I guess it's much the same, I don't know. Hoping the quality is still there. as X-Plane's lacking in quality, it's lacking behind Microsoft at the moment. There is a beacon up here somewhere, a non-directional beacon. You can hone it on, but I'm not going to bother tuning that in. Yeah, there is a method in my madness. There is a small strip near the radar head where you can land and get a helicopter up to the radar head. But this is a VTOL, and they are a bit heavy. Let's see if we can, hopefully if we can, we can run right up there. We'll definitely take a look at it. I always got confused, the Shetland Islands and all, because I never remember which way around they were. The Shetlands are the higher up ones. And there's oil companies here, you know, from North Sea Oil and stuff like that. Right, I think this is it. I think we are approaching radar head, remote radar head they call them. It's right on the top. Scanning for Russians. So we shall fly around, try hovering, and we're too heavy for hovering. We'll land at the strip. There's a short strip here with a rusty old fridge, I remember. Somewhere here. Somewhere below me now. There it is, there it is, there's the strip. It was a maze. I've never seen a fridge that's still operational that was that rusty. Okay, here we are, this is it. You disappear into cloud if you're not careful. Too spark, there we are. Okay, we'll head back to the runway and see if we can hover. Oh, it's closed air brakes out, looking for 250-ish. Where's my runway? 250. There we go. Gear down. Lost the one there again. It's here somewhere. To burn off a bit more fuel actually before we attempt the radar head. So I'm going to land here, end the video, and then we'll go up to the radar head in the next video. Absolutely amazing the way jet fighters can do this. Oop, going backwards. Messed that up a bit. Okay. There we go, brakes on. Thanks for watching.